personally, to get a cover of Thrasher, it's like, it just means like so much. February 2008, so that must have been like, I was like 17, just turned 17. So like, that was just like, wow. All right, here's my second Thrasher cover. I remember Burnett calling me the day before. He just texted me like a day before. He's like, hey, I need a cover for Thrasher, like immediately. Would you be able to shoot it tomorrow? And I was like, dude, yeah, if you find a spot, I'm down. And then Jeff was like, yeah, I got a spot, dude. Like, here's a spot that I found. It's a sick-ass photo, dude. Like, you know, you can't go wrong with Burnett right here. That was rad. All right, so here's my third cover. This is the interview I did for the Possessed Escape video part. But what a photo, dude. Like, so sick. This is my fourth cover of the Scare of the Year. This is when I got Scare of the Year. This is in Hawaii on the SOTY trip, you know, fucking got the cover of Thrasher. So, so stoked, dude. And it's like, you know, and then you get Scare of the Year. I mean, you know, what else I can ask for? Like, in, you know what I mean? I did what I wanted to do.
You know what time it is.
So why I came back to Colombia was because of COVID. COVID started while I was here, and the airport was shut down for a year. And then when I moved back here, it was just really good to be back with my mom, with my friends, just like the roots that I grew up with the city, with the culture, speaking Spanish again, eating the food from here. Through the whole year being here, I kind of fell in love with the city again.
So right now, we are one of my favorite skate parks right here in Medellin, Colombia. This is like my go-to skate park to warm up. It's a cool one because like right at the beginning of a huge bridge. And you can see the city in the back. But yeah, this is definitely one of my favorite parks here in Medellin. Like, it's just a really fun one.
Just a little bit of chicken, you know, for a quick lunch. Woo! So right now we are at this cool spot. It's called 12 de Octubre. It's just like a beautiful view, you know what I mean? It's like, I come here and skate all the time. It's like a little plaza kind of vibe. People put flat bars here and they skate the bank right here too. And it's like a really good spot for just to get gnarly. And then before we used to use the motorcycle to skate this spot, but because the security guard just, they don't let us put the motorcycle here. So now we gotta use the bungee cord, and it's just as good. It's actually better because no noise, nothing, and just do your thing, so. God damn it!
So right now we're going to the mini ramp where I grew up skating. My homie who used to sponsor me when I was a kid, his name is Mauricio. That's where the mini ramp was, next to his skate shop. So that's where I used to go there like almost every day to practice and learn new tricks. And yeah, it was really good times.
In Medellin, there's like two parts of the city, the north and the south. The north is kind of like the hood, and I'm from the north. I grew up in the north because I grew up in the hood. In the hood, there's more like this kind of type of spots to skate, like just going off like some sort of like sidewalk into a hill.
is like some real hood in Colombia. I didn't grow up around here. I grew up in the hood, but not this hood. I was a little bit more like middle class hood.
Skating here is amazing. Like if you come here, you're gonna fall in love with the fucking streets of Colombia. It's like, it's just pure, it's kind of like SF style. People are very passionate about skateboarding here, and that's where I got my passion from.
Fuck yeah!
Give me some.
Fuck yeah!
So right now, we're at this place, like it's called Los Alumbraditos here in Medellin. They do this once a year, and it's kind of like Christmas lights in the middle of the bridge. Like I used to come here growing up. This is one of the places that like come here just on Christmas time with your family, you know, walk alone for like a mile watching the Christmas lights, and it's pretty cool.
I think, you know, because I grew up so tough, so rough, so poor, that kind of like, it was my motivation to do something in life, you know, and at the age of 10 years old, I found skateboarding. Life is about like challenging yourself, struggle, but the best part is like enjoying your life, you know, live your life good, like positive, do good things for people, and just like live it up, you know, that's what I'm about.